How is it going today, my friends? As always, I hope you all are having yourselves a fantastic day. Today's video is going to be a childhood story. Now, I didn't have the greatest or the safest childhood, because most of the stories I have to tell about it are pretty much me almost dying half of the time. People really seem to enjoy when YouTubers talk about their childhood stories and stuff that's happened to them in the past, so here we are, with me, talking about how I cracked my head open. Yeah, I wasn't the smartest kid whatsoever. I'm the type of person who goes out and bodyboards in hurricane swells, so that kind of gives you a description as to how stupid I am, but that is a different time I almost died. This one is 100% my fault. Like, literally one of the single stupidest things I have ever done. So you know the windowsills in your house, obviously. Everybody has windowsills on windows. Basically the ones in my house back in Florida, they're marble. And instead of it being like a rounded edge, it's a cornered edge. So it's just kind of, you know, it's square. It's like this. It's just like a cornered marble edge, right? So me being the genius that I am, I take this cat called Leo, I'm just holding him in my arms for some apparent reason. I just decided to fucking bolt across the house. Like Usain Bolt style, just sprinting across, running around circles in the kitchen. Like I was just being a complete fucking retard, right? This is what I do. I run towards the couch in the family room and I jump. I literally put full force, just jump, and I just lean back like this with the cat, right? So my head going down like this. The back of my head literally just hits the corner of that marble and it's just like I jump and wham! Just smack the back of it. Yeah, it was bloody. It was painful, and it gets worse. So I'm sitting there crying my eyes out because I'm still a little fucking kid, right? I'm bleeding all over the place. And we're on the way to the hospital. They've just got a towel on the back of my head, and I'm just sitting in somebody's lap like, this fucking hurts. This is very uncomfortable. Is my brain still in there? So yeah, we get to the hospital, right? And you would think because it's called an emergency room, you know, you go there for emergencies. You would think someone who is bleeding out of the back of their head severely wouldn't have to wait in the waiting room. I sat in the waiting room with a bloody towel on the back of my head, bleeding out for a fucking hour. Thank you, healthcare. I appreciate it. I don't really blame the hospital or anything, but I totally blame the hospital. Like I said, it gets worse. Sitting in the waiting room wasn't even that bad. The pain really wasn't that bad, but they bring me into this room. It's just got this white table. It's got some sketchy doctors that aren't even looking at me. They just lay me down. They don't say a fucking thing. They don't say, hey, prepare yourself. We're about to give you the worst pain of your fucking life. No, no. They just set me down and they say, stay. So I'm sitting there like, okay, what the fuck are they about to do? They're gonna glue my head? They're gonna stitch my head? What's gonna happen? They don't give me an anesthetic. They don't poke me in the arm with a needle. They don't give me a warning. They literally just walk in the room, grab my legs, grab my arms, pin me down, and they open a drawer. What could be in this drawer? A fucking stapler. They hold me down, open this drawer, and bring out a fucking head stapler. I mind you, no anesthetic. I'm still in fucking pain, and I'm a child. I am not the person I am today. I don't have any pain tolerance back then. Literally, they take this fucking head stapler, this stapler meant for stapling heads. Looked like a normal ass stapler, I mind you. The only thing special about it was the fucking staples inside. Anyway, they're holding me down. I'm trying to squirm, I mind you, and they say, stay still. It's only gonna hurt a little. Can you just imagine sitting there and you feel something press on your head and then you just hear boom? Hold on, let me give you a better description of that. Boom! Because he had to go into my skull, this motherfucker smashes the stapler down. Not once, but twice. So I am like literally 7 or 8 years old and I have just went through the most traumatic fucking thing in the world. Like getting a staple to the arm, that's pretty fucking bad. A full grown man slamming a head stapler on the top of your head? No wonder I didn't remember this. No wonder I wanted to forget about this fucking experience. It was a definite life lesson. I learned not to be a fucking idiot, because that was the last time I ever cracked my head open, no lie. Of course, since then, I have almost drowned a couple of times, but that's a different scenario, okay? That's not stupidity, it's more of adventurous that kind of got me fucked over in those stories. But yeah, people. I was not a very smart child. I was not a careful child. To be honest, they probably didn't use any anesthetic or anything like that because I was such an idiot and they were like, let's teach him a lesson. Let's just staple his fucking head without giving him any painkillers. He'll be fine. I mean, look at me. I'm okay, right? I think I turned out all right. Thank you all so much for watching today's video. If you would please leave a thumbs up if you enjoyed the story, that would be awesome. It would also let me know that you would like me to tell you more childhood stories. Like I said, I wasn't the brightest kid on the fucking planet. I've got a couple more, so definitely let me know if you'd like to see more with that thumbs up button. And as always, my friends, I hope you all have yourselves a fantastic day. A farewell and a goodbye. Here comes the... Woo! Do it for the love, yes, I-
I do. So you don't care about the money? Well, yes, it's true. And I'm so blessed to be fulfilling my destiny.